The objective of the video is to learn how to apply VLOOKUP in Microsoft Excel. We have taken an example of a sample data of Gyan Setu training in which we have the employee data. So as you can see, this is the information we have. We have the employee ID, we have the name of the employees, and this is the department, some sample data for the phone number and the address, and maybe the bank account number and the cab number provided by the company. As we can see, we have the data only for 11 employees. You can see here, this is starting from 1001 to 1011. So in this case, in case we need to find out the data for the particular employees with the employee ID Gyan1005, Gyan1001, Gyan1011 and Gyan1008. Let's suppose we need to find out the data, who all employees are these and which department they are into, and what is the other information for phone, address, account number and the cab number. So as you can see, the Gyan1005 ID, his name is Gopal, department is finance and phone number is this one. So this is the identity which we are looking for. You may be wondering, if we can see the information on our screen, then why do we need to apply the VLOOKUP formula? Definitely VLOOKUP formula may not be required in this case, but when we have a large set of data, maybe around 11,000 employees or maybe 5 lakh employees, and if we need to find out the information for some particular employees, we need VLOOKUP formula in that case, because it's very hard to find out the data one by one. Now we'll understand how to apply a VLOOKUP formula. So the objective of this video is, we need to find out the name for the Gyan1005. So here we have to apply some formulas. Before I start with the formula, first we need to understand there are some limitations in VLOOKUP, like this is our lookup value. Lookup value means the value which we are going to search in the master database. Then we have the lookup column. Lookup column means the column in which we are going to search this lookup value. As you can see, Gyan1005 is present in this column. And then we have the table array. Table array is nothing but the complete data. So this will be the table array. Now VLOOKUP has some limitations. The lookup value should be unique in the lookup column. As we can see, Gyan1005 is present in this lookup column. Let's suppose if I change this value to Gyan1005. And here we want to find out the name of the employee against Gyan1005. So if we have two employees with the same employee ID, this means the data will not be correct. So we need to make sure the lookup value should always be unique in this lookup column. Then only we can apply the VLOOKUP formula. Next we have the lookup column. VLOOKUP has some limitation that the lookup column should be the first column. As you can see, this is the first column of your table array. You may be wondering, why can't we start the table array from cab number? Why we started it from the employee ID? This is the limitation with VLOOKUP. When we have employee ID as the lookup value, so the table array needs to be start from the employee ID itself. It has to be the first column. If you are selecting the table array from cab number, the output will not come. Next we have, VLOOKUP can return field values present to the right of the lookup column. This means the formula can give the information only to the columns which are present to the right side of the lookup column. As you can see, if there is any column to the left of the lookup column, so that is not a part of table array. So if that is not a part of table array, we cannot find the information as well. So I hope you must be clear with the three limitations, which are very important for the interview perspective. So Next we will come to the formula. I want to find out the name of the employee for Gyan 1005. So what I'll do is, first I'll write the formula, which is Vlookup. Then I need to enter the lookup value. What will be the lookup value for this formula is Gyan 1005, which is A21, comma. Then we have to enter the table array. As I told you, the table array cannot start from cab number. If it is starting from cab number, then it will give us an error. Let me take an example. I'll start it from cab number. Let's see if we are getting the output or not. Next we have the column index number. Column index number is something, since we need to find out the name of the employee, so name of the employee is basically the third column of this table. You can see cab number is the first column, employee ID is the second column, and name of the employee is the third column, which we need to find out. So this should be 3, comma. So every time we need the exact match, either we can write false or we can write 0. Enter. You will see you have got an error, and this error is mainly because of we started the table array from A4. Table cannot start from A4. This lookup column should be the first column, as we can see the limitation to the right side of the sheet. So how we can change it is, I'll just change A to B. Now you may be wondering, we need to find out the name of the employee, then why we are getting the department of Gyan 1005? This is mainly because the table started from B4 to G16. This is from where the table actually started. But now the name of the employee is the second column of the table array. This is not the third column, since we have written 3 in our formula. So that is why it is returning the department against the lookup value. So what we need to do is, we can change 3 to 2. So now you have the desired output, and you can just copy it and you can paste it down. I hope you all must be clear with the basic fundamentals of Excel, how we copy it and how we paste the data. So then we have the employee name for Gyan 1001, Akshat, Divya and Rohit. Similarly, we can find out the department for these people. Again, the lookup value will not change. This is the unique key. So lookup value will be A21. Table array will again start from B4 to G16. I'll freeze the table array, and the department will now become the third column. So we have finance. This is how we can actually fetch the data from a large database. Next, you must be thinking, okay, we can find out phone number, we can find out the address, we can find out the account number, but how to find out the cab number? Because cab number is not a part of the table array. So what you need to do is, you can just cut this data and you can paste it after your, I'll just resize the column. Maybe you can just paste it after this lookup column. So how you can apply the formula now, equal to VLOOKUP. This will be your lookup value, A21. And now the table array will change from B4 to H16. Since you can see the cab number column is after this employee ID, so we can easily apply the formula. Now the column index number will be, first column is your employee ID, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this will become 7, the column index number, and then 0. So you can see you have the cab number. So this is how you can use your VLOOKUP formula. A lot of times people ask, do we really need to write the formula again and again? Like, we entered the formula for name of the employee, then again we need to write the formula for department, again we need to write the formula for phone number, and so for address, account number and cab number. No, we really don't need to write the formula again and again. How you can do it in a single go? Equal to VLOOKUP, lookup value, and then your table array will always be B4 to H16. Now the column index number is the critical part, because when you have to find out the name of the employee, the column index number is 2, but when you have to find out the department, the column index number becomes 3. So this is one value which is going to change again and again. So how we are going to do it? We'll use the match function. So in match function, the lookup value will become A21. This is the value. This will not be the lookup value. Since we are going to find out the name of the employee, so this will become the lookup value, comma. Table array is something we are going to find out where name of the employee is present in this top row. So this will become the table array. And then exact match 0. So this part we have written for the column index number. Last we have the exact match or approximate match. So this will always be 0. If you are copying the same formula, you will not get the output again. Like I'll do it, I'll just copy the formula and I'll apply it to all the fields. You will observe the output will not come. Why the output is not coming? Let's study this part. The moment you copy the formula from column B to column C, what is happening is the lookup value is changing to B21, but this should not change. Lookup value should always be A21 for all the columns. So what we can do is we can just freeze the A21 column. And one more thing we need to take care, if we are copying the formula and if we are going down, so this 21 should change to 22, then 23. So this should not be fixed. Only the column A should be fixed in this criteria. So this is the one change which we have to do. Next, in the table array, definitely we don't need to make any change. But if we come to the match part, now what is happening is when I copied this formula from B21 to C21, you will see this lookup value is changed to C20. This is absolutely fine, but if we are going down, now we have to see the lookup value for this part should not be B21, which is Gopal. This should always be name of the employee, because name of the employee is the lookup value which we are actually trying to match in this top row. So what we can do is we can just fix this lookup value. So I have fixed the row 20, but as we are moving right, so this B should not be fixed. The B should change to C, because for this column, this is the lookup value is B20. But when we are copying the data from B20 to the right column, the lookup value should change for C20, which is actually the department. So this B dollar, I'll just remove it, and I'll try to copy the formula. You will see with a single go, we have got the output for all the fields. So this is how you can do it. I understand this part may be a bit tricky, how we have converted this dollar, from which position we need to remove it. But if you think about it logically, you can understand it better. Thank you.